I guess we have to talk about first about the Neanderthals. The Neanderthals are the true natives of Europe. They arrived here around 400,000 years ago and went extinct only relatively recently, like 40,000 years ago, something like that. They stay here until the early modern humans arrive and they intermingle with them, or then wipe them out. They form a group which we know as WHG, Western Hunter Gatherers. So these guys stay here hunting, gathering, as the name says. They migrate through whole of Europe. They will be differentiated by the EHG, who are their Eastern counterparts, and their SIHG, the Scandinavians. These groups will be separated by geographic barriers, but understand that they are very different inside of these groups, okay? So SIHG will be quite similar to Danish VHG, but we have to put the limit somewhere. So VHG stay here for quite a lot of millennia, till the Neolithic farmers arrive from Anatolia, okay? Maybe they originated first from the Natufian peoples in the Levant, but they go through Anatolia and they expand through all of Europe, okay? They expand through the Mediterranean, north of Africa, and they get to the British Isles too. So they bring farming, they bring cattle, and this was around some 9,000 years ago, okay? The Neolithic starts in Europe with them. The EEF, they have a lot of acronyms, and they are sometimes early European farmers, they are sometimes Anatolian Neolithic farmers. Some of these letters, they have their own specific meaning. They are referring to a specific cluster or a time, but they are mostly the same people. EEF survives mostly untouched today in the island of Sardinia. The Sardinians are the most special people genetically wise. After these guys, they create their societies, their languages and everything, and the Indo-Europeans start expanding. Indo-Europeans, of course, as you know, they bring their languages, and probably they spoke Proto-Indo-European in the south of Russia, okay? We're talking the steppes, the Caspian steppes. They are mostly associated with the Kurgan cultures and specifically with the Yamnaya people. So these guys bring chariots and horses and they start migrating through Europe. Probably they brought a lot of diseases too. The population plummeted, okay? And it looks like, by the genetic evidence, that they replaced most of the native males in Europe. It was first thought that some societies survived this expansion, like the Iberians or the old Basque people, but genetic evidence shows that they also arrived to these civilizations, but it looks like they integrated or created new ones, preserving the language that was native there. These steppe guys, they are sometimes called Yamna, Yamnaya, maybe Kurgan, maybe A-N-E. The closest human group today related to the ancient Yamnayas are probably the Eastern Baltic people. We are talking Karelians, Estonians, these guys. So yeah, genetics, it's beautiful, it's stunning. It's the unknown, the vast unknown waiting for us to be deciphered. And it's in your bones. If you have European ancestry, some of these guys I've just mentioned probably are, surely are your ancestors. This is just so you can understand these charts and maps that float around the internet. These are huge, vast amounts of people we are talking about throughout millennia, okay? We are just classifying them with some letters to understand, conveniently understand and explain the most important migrations, events that happened in Europe and that determined our DNA today. It is just so much human biomass we are talking about, and we only have like a bunch of samples of each every one of these human groups that populated this whole continent. There were so many generations, so many cultures and different peoples, and it's all gone to dust. And yeah, it's incredible that we can today reconstruct what happened, why these events, these migrations. Yeah, it's stunning, beautiful. So yeah, that's a basic simplification. If you want me to explain these groups a bit in detail, just stay around. If you don't want it, then I'll keep it to myself. And now I will do some pull-ups.